Welcome to our studio. Today we plan to talk about a very important process. This is Bologna process, and we will talk about role of Bologna process in education, in higher education, and we will talk about collaboration, of course, with Bologna University, which is the place where Bologna process was signed. And today we have our guest, honorable guest, Vice President of Bologna University on Eastern European countries, Professor Stefano BIANCHINI. You're welcome.
Thank you for inviting me. Mm-hmm. I'm very pleased.
And we know that Bologna University is the oldest university in the world. And if you say a few words about Bologna University and about the way how Bologna University actually moved in higher education.
Well, yes, it's true. You're right. University of Bologna is the oldest in Europe, maybe the oldest, oldest in the world. I would say we started lectures in 1088 with the Faculty of Law. Actually, there are documents that shows that lectures started even earlier. But anyway, we celebrate the anniversary starting from 1088, when students, by the way, I have to say, created this private university, separating this university from the religious studies and seminars, you know. So this was the first secularized university in Europe, and the students paid and hired the professor with their own tuition fees autonomously. Then in the 12th century, the Holy Emperor, Roman Emperor, Friedrich I, offered specific guarantees of autonomy to the University of Bologna and privileges to its students. This led also to a certain crisis between the students and the municipality because they wanted to protect and defend their own privileges, and they wanted even more privileges. This led to a crisis that was overcome in the end when the municipality offered to the students the possibility to cover directly the expenses of the salaries of the professors. So since that moment, the University of Bologna became a public university. And now the time over the years, let's say, the University of Bologna expanded on different disciplines. We offer all the possible disciplines in this moment, and we have in this moment a university of 85,000 students, 5 campuses, and very committed in the implementation of the Bologna process, although we are not responsible for the Bologna process in itself, because the process was launched by the ministries of higher education of the European Union that convened to Bologna, because Bologna is the alma mater studiorum, as we can say, so the first university in Europe. So this is, in a nutshell, what the University of Bologna is today. Yeah?
It seems University of Bologna is a great place to study, great place to be, great place to do research. And how Bologna process helps you and helps us to be a part of global education system and to create more international changes and international programs. Can you tell us a little bit more about your international programs?
Well, yes, the University of Bologna, you're right about the city and about the it's a very old city with remnants of the Etrurian period and the pre-Roman time, and buildings of the Middle Ages. We have still the building of the university of the 15th, 16th century, and a very interesting museum of the university with the first tools that have been used, particularly in medicine, and an extremely interesting anatomic room for lectures during the 16th century about medicine. So this is just what is the heritage, let's say, the heritage of the Bologna University. But you are focused on one key point.
International,
yes, but it's not only contemporary. We have a long tradition of internationalization because we have different colleges that have been created in Bologna because Bologna attracted the students from all the Italian peninsula and from outside Italy, from beyond the Alp mountains. So we had students that were coming from Hungary, from Spain, from Germany, from Poland, and we have the coat of arms of the students that were coming. So internationalization is a long tradition of the University of Bologna. This is what I wanted to say. And from this point of view, we are particularly committed in internationalization because it's obvious university means universal. If we are not international, we are not a university. This is one of the key points. Internationalization means possibility of developing courses in different languages, attracting visiting professors, attracting students from all over the world, studying together with the Italian students. This is extremely important for our students to receive and to meet students from all over the world, but also to send students outside. So we have programs for incoming and outgoing students that are coming just for a mobility for one semester or two semesters, because very often they prolong their stay for a second semester. Or we have enrolled students from different, from all over the world to different programs that we are offering. In this moment, we have 70 programs, international programs. 49 are programs in English, and most of them are joint degrees, double degrees, multiple degrees. So this is a specific commitment that the current rector would like to increase further to strengthen the international presence of the students to our university, because as you can understand, the internationalization has a great effect under different levels, but particularly because it strengthens the transversal skills, how to work together with people that have different experiences, that have different methodologies, because they come from different methodological studies, approaches from different universities. And I think this is extremely useful for all our students, for the incoming students, for the Italian students that can learn more about the world and more about the contents that the critical thinking that has been created around the world, because when we have also visiting professors, they are coming with their own specific methodology, with their own approaches, and these offer different way how to look at the world, different lens to our students, and this is a strong education for a globalized and a transnational work.
I see you are very excited to have international students. But can you tell us what the most popular subjects or faculties, what do your students, incoming students, like to study at your university the most?
Well, the schools that are particularly attracting students in our university are particularly political science, international relations, definitely, languages, humanities, particularly because we have also, you have to consider also that we have studies on cultural heritage, architecture, and even fashion. So the great majority is gone. But we have also foreign students, and we are launching lots of programs in economics and in engineering. And now we are starting also in physics and medicine. So we have a broader, broad approach from this point of view. Although it's true that the great number, let's say, of incoming and outgoing is connected particularly to political science, because we include international relations in political science and languages. These are the two, and then humanities. These three are the most attractive faculties. Broader number of English programs in addition to economics.
Okay, but you also mentioned that sometimes ago that you have some specific programs designed for Eastern Europe and Central Asia.
This is true. We have a specific program for the campus. Well, I have to say that the University of Bologna is structured on 5 campuses. So our students are not learning only in Bologna, but also in Romagna region, where we have new campuses, very well developed, with excellent facilities, and with specific target, identity. So, for instance, in the case of Forlì, because you have mentioned, we have a master program of 2 years in East European studies with languages, 3 level of Russian, for instance, Serbo-Croatian, Slovak, Bulgarian, Lithuanian languages, but also politics of these areas, we have economics of these areas, we have sociology, even students are studying the movies from these areas, and I have to say also Central Asia. We have a specific course on Central Asia and in Caucasus, and this means that we have a potential group of interest of our students to study in prospectively Central Asian problems, issues, particularly the Eurasian Economic Union, the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. And we have also, I have to say, a specific research project that we have developed as a department recently on Russia and China. So this is something that is connected. Then, if I can say something about also the campuses, we have also aerospatial engineering in Forlì and the School of Interpreters. Then we have in Cesena, for instance, psychology and agriculture, in Rimini, economy of tourism, and in Ravenna, environmental protection and cultural heritage. So you see that there is a clear focus on each of these programs, and a new PhD the program on political science will be opening for Lee next academic year.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned that you have a lot of outgoing students, yeah, and probably one of the tools to have students to go out to learn more about other countries, summer schools.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about summer schools, where you go and where you send your students.
Well, we promote our summer schools, definitely, but also we have students that like to go, mm-hmm, to different summer schools. They ask.
Tell us about both. And outside.
Yes, we have, for instance, one winter summer school on human rights, for instance, that is also organized with the High School of Economics in Moscow. 1 year is in Italy, one year is in Russia. Mm-hmm. We have other summer schools on different aspects, for instance, on pedagogy, on psychology. And in economics, financial aspects, but also we have interest in to send the students. Mm-hmm. And we have lots of students that even autonomously are asking us opportunities, which opportunities other universities offer. So the idea of sending students to summer schools is a very important aspect, also because this is a way how to strengthen the cooperation also among programs. Mm-hmm. So first summer school, then, for instance, joint programs that can lead to double degrees or joint degrees this later on. Yeah.
And you know, in the conclusion, probably let's talk about one issue. I just learned that it's your first visit to Kazakhstan,
yeah,
and first visit to Almaty, and first visit to Kazakh National University. So what's your expectation about development of collaboration in future?
Well, I have to say that my expectation is very high, because we have included Kazakhstan among our priorities, particularly for the area of my competency. And from this point of view, I expect that, particularly because we have already started since long time our cooperation with al-Farabi, thanks to you particularly, but also we think that we have a great potential in terms of developing a strong exchange of students for, let's say, at least a semester. Mm-hmm. This will be very welcome in our university. And also, I would say, in a cooperation in capacity building projects, in Erasmus Plus projects, and why not in research? For instance, in some topics of common concern. Why not, for instance, in the future also in about Eurasian studies?
Okay. Thank you very much. We had a wonderful representative, wonderful guest, Professor Stefano Bianchini, Vice President of Bologna University on Eastern European countries. So thank you very much for coming, and thank you very much for sharing your ideas with us.
Thank you for inviting me. Thank you.